Dames en heren, mag ik vragen om te gaan zitten? Ja, ik word gestart.
Oh, oké. Okay.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to this historic event, this morning, normally Professor Wolf from the VAB would give the speech, but he couldn't make it. So Philip asked me at the very last moment, in fact this morning, to talk, to introduce this festival. So I haven't read anything, in fact. I was just going to come over here to listen like you guys, to enjoy myself, and all of a sudden I'm here, so I have to improvise a little bit. What I do have in common with Professor De Waal is that we are both researchers on a project called the Winter Garden Research Program. This group wants to do research, on the phenomenon between artistic Western practices, the relation between those practices and art practices all over the world, in fact. So it's mainly geographical, but it can also be theoretical. And that's where I think here there's a link with what we'll see today. It is geographical, but it's also theoretical in the sense that avant-garde poetry is a marginal way of doing, conducting poetry, which will eventually also have an impact on mainstream poetry or mainstream culture in general. And I think that's what we will see and explore in the next days. Not just practical, but also there will be also our performances, as I understood. So it's going to be really fantastic. Okay, I would say enjoy yourselves, and yeah, I hope you do. Bye.
Okay.
Thank you, Stefan, and I would now like give the floor to somebody who we just see the hat on top of the stage, which sort of suggests that she's sitting underground. So I would like now to give the floor to Professor Laura Lopez, who's live with us from New Zealand. So I need to say to her, Buenas tardes, Laura, and you have the floor.
Buenas tardes, Philippe. Thank you for having me here. I hope you enjoy the festival there in the whole conference. Okay. Do you want, should I start then?
Yes, please.
Okay, so do you hear me well?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Well, the topic of this presentation is critical approaches to experimental poetry. So I'm going to give a little introduction about this. So I will start with saying that there are many possible approaches that we can use to study current and historical experimental poetic practices. There is no magic formula to say what a experimental poem means and how should we give life on the meaning of the poem, because there are many factors that are very complex. So we have to use different approaches, and all of them, I think, are partially valid. Okay. In my opinion, some relevant frameworks of study include different schools of thought, such as structuralism in linguistic theories of the sign, verbal and visual semiotics, the gestalt theories and visual thinking, media and materiality, intermedia and intermediality studies, We also have other approaches from the typographic form of the letters and the visual cultures. And also, one of the newest frameworks that I've been in touch with is frame semantics and embodied cognition. In my opinion, all these theories contribute in their particular way to the process of meaning, even if sometimes their basic tenets conflict among each other. When reading or decoding an experimental poem, we can use more than one approach, but we also need to take into account that theoretical frameworks are not fixed on stone. And the same theoretical approaches that were developed or originated in a specific year or decade, they evolve as well. So they are also reconceptualizing their own ideas. So we have to take that into consideration as well. And also some scholars can be part of different schools of thought, such as Roland Barthes, who work on structuralism and also develop post-structuralist concepts as well. So since these theories evolve and their basic tenets are reinterpreted through time, we have to select the more useful aspects of each school to specific practices that we find in experimental poetics. Another problem is that experimental poetry itself is not a very well-defined practice, and it includes many different styles or genre. So what I did was I thought about two main lines of study design, which the first ones were the structuralists, starting with Ferdinand de Saussure at the beginning of the 20th century. I think that is a key point to understand or to analyze texts in general. And so, starting from there, we have a different sub-schools, I would say, or scholars who specialize in different dimensions of design. So we start with structuralism, and then we go with semiotics, which it has also developed from verbal semiotics to visual semiotics. Then we will touch a little bit of media theorists and theorists of the technosphere, which are also contributing to an expanded notion of the media, of the text and design. So we will see some notes from McLuhan, Kittler, Hales, and others. Okay, another relevant aspect that may be useful to include in an analysis of experimental poems is the artist's writings about art. Not only their works, but also what they write about their works. So many of these artists have advanced theoretical positions that are being considered systematically by diverse schools. In the field of cognition, media studies, and embodiment. And some of these poets and painters and artists in general that I find influential are Dick Higgins, Edward Bocard, Charles Olson, and also the completists in the 50s and 60s, although I am not going to include them here. Let's go to... Usually in academia, we don't study much of experimental poetry, or we don't, you know, there are no classes or courses specialized in experimental poetry. What we learn at university usually is to read poetry, I mean, to decode, to analyze verbal poems, which I call here conventional poetry. Discursive poetry that is made only or exclusively with written language, verbal.
May I just interrupt?
Yes.
Because,
yes.
Yes. You had a PowerPoint presentation.
Yes.
Can you share your screen with us? Because we are just looking at the camera and.
You don't see the PowerPoint.
No, we don't see the PowerPoint.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, my.
No, it's not a problem. I mean,
thank you for telling me. Okay, okay.
Saying.
Yes.
Okay.
sorry.
It's not that we don't like to see.
I thought that you were. share screens. Okay. Now you see it.
Not yet.
Yes,
now,
okay.
Now we are seeing it.
Thank you. Sorry. So basically what I did in this slide is to kind of synthesize or contrast some of the points that we have to take into account when reading or studying a verbal poem or an experimental poem. So one thing that we find right away is that in conventional poetry, we have only to deal with one medium, which is the written language, and we have the poem usually in the page. So there is a 2D, two-dimensional page, and that's it, only one surface. So we have only one medium, one written language based upon the document.